Hello, everyone. Did you ever good on neighbor? Nikki conversion to a no kind of fan chat one year. And welcome to another amazing video. And happy third anniversary to one of the best drama movie of 2019. Because even Frozen 2 is my favorite movie of 2019. But what's my favorite movie? What is my favorite drama movie of 2019? Well, it has to be Joker Phoenix, starting Joker Phoenix, Robbie Deano, and the girl from Deadpool 2 as Dominoes. Anyway, guys, I don't want to tell a story because the main reason why I'm calling this a Halloween review the main reason why I'm doing this review on Halloween reviewing because I saw a lot of people dressing up as Joker because I was Joker before on Halloween. So sorry, guys. And speak of Halloween, maybe I could be Doctor Strange or James Bond or the guy from Top Gun Maverick, which is Tom Cruise. Anyway. Anyway, guys, so let me tell you my experience of this movie. Sorry, guys, no joke. This movie was my very first rated R movie I ever saw in theaters, which honestly, I was completely happy because I don't understand why some people out there think this movie's dangerous. Dude, have you not even seen John Wick movie? Have you not even seen a ending scene when Once Upon a Time in Hollywood? Because the ending of Once Upon a Time in Hollywood is how to be one of the most brutal and grotesque singing I ever seen for Once Upon a Time in Hollywood movies. And sorry, guys, and honestly, I really enjoy this film because this film is a really aged well, and this movie is dark, this movie is gruesome, this movie is bloody, this movie is gory, this movie is amazing. I really love this movie to death. Anyway, guys, so when this movie came out, a lot of people was afraid that this movie is going to be dangerous. And no joke, it was the FBI cop was arriving in the theaters and check people's backpack and make sure they don't have any weapons and guns. Are you kidding me? How this society is going to be even worse? How does society get even worse? Within your stupid society, movie is not the blame. Blame on the news. Blame on the random people. Don't blame the movie. Who does that? It's kind of reminding me of that people blaming violence because of video game. Honestly, people need to stop blaming entertainment stuff. Honestly, you know what system you should blame? You should blame the news because every time the news come on about the news, a lot of people say, you know what? We do the exact same thing. No. No, rated R movie's not dangerous. Joker's not dangerous. At the end of the day, this movie's not dangerous. And rated R movie's not dangerous. People, you need to cut that out. That is honestly one of the worst things of 2019. Because I cannot stand of the backlash of this movie. Because this movie is a really awesome masterpiece movie. But anyway, guys, I was so disappointed that this movie did not win for Best Picture at the Oscars. But honestly, thank God Parasite won over this, because even I enjoyed the film, but I think Parasite is a much better 2019 movie than Joker. But anyway, do I have any negative about this movie? No, I don't have any negative about this movie, because if I get one negative about this movie, I will be a terrible movie critic. And sorry, guys, let's get my positive of this movie, shall we? And before I talk about the positive, I'll probably you guys are wondering or scratching your head saying, Hey Nick, it's 2001. Wait a minute, I thought you already did a review on Joker. Guys, my Joker review is a 20-minute video, which honestly, I don't want to make a 20-minute video anymore because the 20-minute video is stupid, it's longer, and make my audience to bored to death. So I'm trying my best not to make my review more 20-minute videos. So before I did that, in a lot of time, I just really get sick and tired of it. And sorry, guys, and I am trying my best not to make this review a 20-minute video because honestly, I have a lot of stuff to talk about of this movies. Anyway, now let's get to the positive. Honestly, I do think the story is really original because we've never seen this kind of story for Joker movies. And kid, do not watch this movie, because if you're a Joker fan, kid, I recommend you don't watch it. So, don't want the kids to watch this, because this movie is dark, it's gruesome, it's violent, it's dangerous, like most people said, which is stupid. And so, yeah, and honestly, I really enjoy the story of the film. And the characters, honestly, my favorite character of the film is tied with of Moe Franklin or started as Robert De Niro. Robert De Niro is in this movie. And so, yeah, the same actor, he was in the stupid Shark Tale and the stupid comedy movie called Dirty Grandpa, because the only comedy film that he's in right now is had to be Amsterdam. Yes, people, it's a comedy film. So, it's like a drama and a comedy film. So, don't get your mind twisted. And sorry, guys, and Robert De Niro in this movie, he did a really good job. And this is honestly one of his best performances he ever did. So let's see his best performance from The Godfather Part 2. So let's see The Godfather Part 2 will be replaced as his best performance ever, because I haven't seen The Godfather Part 2. I saw the first movie, but overall, I'm just going to watch the movie during my fall break, due to, you know, what is happening in my fall break. So I don't want to talk about it. And sorry, guys, and Joaquin Phoenix as the Joker. For the Joker, this is honestly one of my favorite Joker of all time, because honestly, take that back. Joaquin Phoenix is my second favorite Joker. My number one favorite Joker, we already know that Heath Ledger Joker is the best Joker of humankind, because Heath Ledger as Joker, that's my kind of Joker. But Joaquin Phoenix, he did a really good job as a Joker, but I do prefer Heath Ledger as Joker. Just like that one video of my Joker Nuggets trying to dress up like a Joker planking on Jeffrey. If you haven't seen my Joker Nugget, I recommend you don't watch it, kid, because it's TVMA. Don't let your kids watch it. Anyway, and Arthur Fleck's mother, she is a really likable character. And Thomas Wayne, well, sometimes Thomas Wayne be really mean spirit, but everyone in the Gotham City was really mean spirit. Like especially that one scene when the bully hit the sign and Joker and kick him. Honestly, that scene was really dark. Honestly, the first time I saw this movie in theater, when I saw that scene, I feel so bad with Arthur Fleck as a Joker, and that's why he become at the most creepiest and disturbing character from the DCEU. And honestly, this movie is not your typical DCEU. This movie is a non-DCEU movie. But this is honestly one of my second favorite It's not a DC movie? Let's try it again. Sorry, guys, and this is honestly one of my second favorite non-DCEU movie. Because honestly, my favorite non-DC movie I ever seen, it's had to be Robert Pattinson as Batman. So let's hope Robert Pattinson and Joaquin Phoenix would meet together in the non-DC universe. So that would be pretty cool. And sorry, guys, my favorite scene of the film, it has to be the iconic scene when Joker dances on the stairs. People, who in a white mind want to do it in a real life? If you do it in a real life, and that's me, you're a cuckoo hen at this point. Like, cuckoo in the head. Honestly, I saw the one video, that one dude trying to dance on the stairs, and you got fall down. Whatever. Well, honestly, that's what you get, because honestly, you don't dance on the stairs. Just because you saw the iconic scene of Joker dance on the stairs, it didn't mean you have audacity to do it. So that's really stupid, you ask me. And the violence. Honestly, I don't understand why people think this movie's dangerous. Have you not even seen all the violent movie? Have you not even seen The Godfather? Have you not even seen Taxi Driver? Have you never seen every single John Wick movie? Even I haven't seen John Wick movie, but I'm going to watch it next year for leading up to the fourth movie. So, yeah. And sorry, guys. And in the climax of the film is honestly one of my favorite climax I ever seen for Tom Phillip. And this is a way better Tom Phillip movie than The Hangover Part 3. AKA the worst Tom Phillip movie I ever seen. And thank God the Hangover movie is over. Good rhythm. And the ending of the film. The ending of the film is really dark. And honestly, you know how the ending goes? Let me tell you. And after therapist visit Joker, and Joker was doing the evil laugh, and it got cut. But so Joker just killed the therapist, and they're walking the hallway while the 60 or the 70 or the 50 music playing, and have the end, which I really like the end time card. So yeah, and that's your movie end. Honestly, there's no post-credits scene of the film. There's no post-credits scene of the film. So that's really awesome. So overall, guys, Joker 2019, this is honestly one of the best drama movie of 2019. This movie has some iconic scene when Joker danced on the stairs. People, for the love of God, people, can you please don't do that? Don't do that in progress. If you do, honestly, if you do that in progress, that's, oh my God, that means this war is so crazy. I cannot stand it. So back I was saying, so Joker is honestly one of my favorite Tom Fuller movie I ever seen, next to the Hangover movie, except Part 3. That is honestly one of the worst Tom Fuller movie I ever seen. And Tom Fuller, you did a really good job for directing this movie, because I can see why Tom Fuller take the source material from Joker, for Batman and the Killer Joke, and make this movie, because honestly, this is literally like Batman and the Killer Joke done right. Because my thought on the Batman the Killer Joke, I'm sorry, I agree with Grace Runup. That movie's a piece of crap. I am sorry, that movie's a piece of crap. And sorry guys, I really enjoyed the story of the film. I really enjoyed the character of the film, like Randall death scene. No, people, I'm not talking about Randall from Monster Inc. I'm not talking about that kind of Randall. I'm talking about Randall, which is Arthur Fleck's friend, and the little guy, which I forgot his name is, so I don't know. So overall, guys, Joker, this is honestly one of my favorite Joker movies I ever seen. This is honestly one of my favorite drama movie of 2019. And this is honestly one of my second favorite non-DC movies I ever seen in my life. And I am giving Joker 2019 a 10 out of 10. This is epic, brilliant masterpiece. And I am giving this movie a seal of Nick-Kick awesomeness. Dun dun dun. So yeah, that was my redo movie review of Joker 2019. Tell me what you thought of this movie on the comment section below without spoiler. And sorry guys, and this movie is a highest grossing rated R movie of all time. Sorry Deadpool, sorry Sergeant Party, but I'm probably Joker just beat you guys up in the box office. So sorry about that. But overall, Joker is a really awesome movie, and Joker is honestly one of my favorite rated R movie of 2019. And this is a way better rated R movie than Good Boys. Yeah, screw that. And so, hey guys, if you like this movie, like a Halloween movie, while you put your smile in your... Sorry, I'm gonna try again. That doesn't make no sense once forever. If you like this video, if you want to dance on the stairs, please don't do it. Please, hit the subscribe button, turn on notification, and show this video for the adult, because this video is not for kids. So just because Joker... it's like DC characters, it didn't mean this movie is for kids. No, this movie is not for kids. This movie's blood. This movie has disturbing scene, and this movie has some really gruesome and the most disturbing subway scene, which is my favorite scene of Italian movies. I really enjoyed the subway scene. The subway scene of the film is a really dark scene when all the three grown-up bully Joker, and thank God Arthur Fleck, just stand up for himself and shoot the guy from the subway. And sorry guys, so stay tuned for my more Halloween review week coming pretty soon. And yes people, this review is going on the playlist on Halloween review week. So if you guys have a problem with it, guys, just let me deal with it. It's my YouTube channel, I can do what the heck I want. If I want to put Joker as my Halloween review week, I might do that, because I saw a lot of people dressing up Joker. Hey, just because Joker is not a Halloween character doesn't mean you have audacity to tell me what to do or whatever you want. You don't own my YouTube channel. It's my YouTube channel, not yours. You have your own, just let me do mine. Come on, it's a free country, darn it. I deserve a free country. And sorry guys, I'm not trying to be mean, but I just really get sick and tired of that people telling me what to do. But overall guys, so Joker, epic brilliant masterpiece, 10 out of 10, love it. Sorry guys, subscribe, comment, share with family. Stay tuned for my more Instagram posts in the future, and stay tuned for my new episode of Instagram series on Story File if you're age of 21 and 18, because my series is really getting more adult. But honestly, I'm 21 years old, so I deserve that. And sorry guys, I see you next time. It's all one can teach you too. Have a good day everyone, and I see you guys tomorrow afternoon.
for that, don't I?
What the fuck are you talking about? Stop talking out of your ass, Art. Oh, no! I forgot to punch out.